So thank you for joining us again. And hello to you guys in my audience, in the audience, to the VIP friends that we have here. My goodness, one of my favorite people is here joining us on the VIP couch. Bobo, how are you doing?
Very well, thank
you. You're good?
Yeah.
Thank you. DJ Spindle, what's up? Little known fact, African Queen is all about me. I will prove it. Spindle, huh? Play some music, surprise us.
Yeah, yeah, you are my African Queen.
Hey, is it
all
good?
Just like the sun, lights up my life.
How you doing?
I'm doing well. Huh? Take a seat.
Yes, sir. How fun. Yes.
So, as you can see, guess who I have here?
Hello,
Baba. How are you?
Very well, thank
Tell
you.
Tell them. This song is about me.
Yes, as a matter of fact.
I told you. This song is so about me.
Yes.
So let's get down to what we're here to do today. Talk.
Yep.
So for those of you who are just tuning in, today's guest is the incredible Two-Face. Multiple award winner. Trailblazer in African music. Father, not so recently husband, and personal writer of songs that honor moi. What can I say? Why do they call you Two-Face? How did you choose Two-Face?
For me, Two-Face is a name that represents everybody. You know, because sometimes you call yourself a name, and the name is just, you say, okay, I am the damager. That means you damage things.
So, you know,
I am the crusher. That means you crush things, or whatever it is. But, you know, I wanted a name that would depict me as, you know, me as an artist, somebody that you see on the TV, you read in the papers, you hear on the radio, and then the real me, which is the me that you actually get to meet face to face.
I totally get that.
You know, so that's what Two-Face is all about.
So where did you grow up?
In a couple of places, but basically Nigeria, mostly Nigeria.
Okay.
You know, I've spent time in. I was born in Jos.
Okay.
You know, I spent time in Jos. Spent time in Benue State, my state. Spent time in Enugu, spent time in the U.S., spent time in Lagos.
That's
so
cool.
These places are the places that I have actually grown up in.
Yeah. Where did you go to school?
Some part of my school was in Jos, some part was in Benue.
Which university?
And some part was in Enugu, some part was in... I spent a year in Uni Jos. I did remedial.
University of Jos.
Yeah.
Because that's very popular,
University of Jos. You know.
Yeah.
Then I went to IMT Enugu. Most of my secondary school was in Benue State.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. What I find very interesting about your success story is that it is real. I hear you actually dropped out of university.
I was supposed to go back and continue for.
And then
but that was when the dream for music was like really, really strong. And my whole mind, body, and spirit was like, look, follow this thing up.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, you know what? Let me just pause this for like a year or two.
Since then, I've always been postponing
going back, back.
What are you going to go back to go do?
No, to have
bragging rights.
To have bragging rights.
you know,
that's something. That's something.
Study music? Yeah.
And then to have bragging rights, you know. So yes, wait till they talk.
And I do know that you lost your father very recently.
Yes.
And I'm so sorry about that. May his soul rest in peace.
Yes, sir.
But, they must be so proud of you. They must really.
Yeah, they are. But, you know, they naturally didn't support the idea, you know. But I'm like, I'm just asking for your blessing. Because even if you don't bless me now, I need your blessing. I just need your blessing. But even if you don't, this is where my heart is. And I want to just follow this thing up. And, you know, it took like a year or so before they're like, okay, finally they saw that I was really serious about what I was talking about. So they're
that's
like,
the
okay.
The key word is serious.
You know, so they said, okay, well, since, I mean, from the way we see it, there's nothing we can tell you that will make you continue this thing. So, okay, you know what? Just go for 1 year, follow this thing up, then fall back. We are here. We are ready for you anytime.
Good parenting.
You know, but you know, once I left IMT Enugu and I started following music full time, there was no going back for me anymore. Mm. It was just, it was just, you know, it just started. I mean, it didn't happen immediately. It didn't happen automatically, but it started falling into
gradually,
place gradually.
Gradual.
Yeah.
So I have here, my goodness, and even as I'm sitting with you, I'm reading this and I'm thinking, blimmin' heck. MTV Europe Awards.
Yes, sir.
World Music Awards.
Yes, sir.
Channel All Video Awards.
Yes, sir.
BET Awards.
Yes, sir.
I mean, just to name a few.
Yes, so Mobo, there's still plenty. There's still
that's what I see. I was down here all night. David, you know, I need to know.
But recently, I told them I don't want award again. I want reward.
Reward, I'm telling you. I feel you. The reward, and we'll share it, right?
Yes.
Wow. So, you know, so let's take a look at one of your hit songs. Now, should we take a look?
I want to see a happy face. I want to see a smiley. A land that's full of jolly. I'm ready to go, yeah. Come take me go that place. Where it is happening. Where everybody dancing.
I live abroad, and I've always looked for an easy and convenient way to carry out banking transactions in Nigeria without any hassle.
But now, I can.
With my first diaspora account,
I could monitor cash flow into my account via online banking, save in order to invest in businesses, pay my staff salaries, and even pay money directly into my loved ones' account, like I live in Nigeria. I can explore so many other financial advisory services easily and still use my Naira MasterCard anywhere in the world. Join me. Make the switch to seamless and convenient banking solutions today, wherever you are outside Nigeria. Choose First Diaspora from First Bank.
Every day starts with a vision. And as the saying goes, if you believe you can fly, you will. Flying demands the best of safety procedures, and that is why we are abreast of global standards delivered by top technicians using some of the most advanced technologies. At Arik Air, we don't just believe in flying, we are passionate about the flying experience. Arik Air, Africa's fastest growing airline.
So you started off in a group, didn't you? In a musical group.
Yep.
Uh-huh.
And Plantation Boys.
Yes. And you know, I actually remember them. I think when I first came back to Nigeria, they were reigning.
Yeah.
And you're the breakout star. Was it hard to take the decision to break out, to leave the group?
Yeah.
To leave the others?
Yeah, you know, when you work with people, there's always that, you know, should I, you know. So there's always that difficulty in making
especially
that decision.
Since you guys were so successful.
Yes, mm-hmm. Yes, you understand. So, but for me, I mean, while we were still in the group, we had a contract, actually, and all of us understood that, you know, anytime anybody wants to do their solo album, it's not a prison. Anybody can
Abby?
Do their solo stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, so after like, let me say like 5-6 years, you know, mm-hmm. together, I'm like, okay, you know what? I want to do my solo stuff. You know, and that's how it happened.
And you had, you were successful immediately.
Yeah, did their solo stuff as well.
Yeah, they did. And you were like instant success, as it were. 10 years in this industry.
Yeah.
In your industry. Mm. 10 years of success as a solo artist.
Yeah.
Do you feel successful? When you look in the mirror,
I like that. I like that question.
Do you feel successful?
I don't feel successful right now. The only thing I feel is I am heading towards what I term as successful. Mm-hmm. I'm heading towards that position.
And, so how do you define success?
I just have to. Success is the day that, you know, the day that you can just sit down in your house and say, okay. Oh boy, I beg, book that, tell the pilot to prepare that plane. I just want to go to Bahamas. You know, the day that you don't really have to get up and do anything. That's what me, I look at as. But that is being extra. If I want to break it down, I'll say, you know, the day that I don't have to be scared to get up and work and take some chances. You know, that day, hey, I'll say I'm successful. The day that I won't be scared to experiment on a new type of sound.
Yes.
You know, because I'll be.
Just in case it's not well received.
The day that I'll be scared to do that. The day that I will not be scared to do that.
That is success. So you went from being an entertainer, a musician, and you set up your own record label.
Yep.
Which means that you're now a businessman. So you went from being an entertainer into also the business of entertainment.
Yes, you can say that.
How do you manage the two hats?
I think for me, I'll just say I'm lucky to have a couple of people working with me that are able to, you know, keep these things going.
So you have a good
while
team.
I concentrate on the creative aspect of things.
Okay, so you have this artist signed to you, Dami Crane.
Dami Crane.
Who's about to release an album.
As a matter of fact, the album just came out.
It's come out already. In the business of entertainment that you're now in, as a businessman, it's in your best interest to push all your entertainers, all your artists. Because the better they do, the more money you make.
I mean, that's the idea.
Okay.
Yeah.
But then, aren't you scared one might be more successful than you? Because I'd be like, wait a minute. You know, it was in the pageant. You know when I was doing Miss Nigeria? And someone once said to me that, you know, what if, you know, one of these Miss Girls win Miss Nigeria and then they just, you know, and I'm like, well,
explode
the fact is, I have been here a long, 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 long time.
Yes,
you know,
yes.
And the Yorubas say that no matter how wealthy people become, they can never have as many rags. Exactly. You know, so that's like,
They won't have more.
No matter how successful they get, they can't still match up to the boss.
I'm telling you.
Okay.
That's what it is.
Basically. There's something you're doing right now that I love. I believe that, you know, when God gives us a platform, we're supposed to use it for good, for the social upliftment of ourselves, our immediate community, our country, our people, really. So let's take a break and we'll come back and talk more about that. Hey, what's going on?
Ah, so you haven't heard?
Oh.
Etisalat is giving amazing data value and smartphones at the lowest prices.
With up to 1.5 gigabytes free data sign-up bonus and 100% bonus on all data purchases from 200 MB and above for 12 months. Can I show you some phones?
Get the latest devices at amazing prices at any Etisalat Experience Center or authorized dealers and choose from the blazing fast data and amazing tariffs all on your smartphone network of choice.
Etisalat, now you're talking.
I want to ask you this question because I find there's a difference between people pre-children and post-children. Do you find that? Because so all this, you know, this platform that you have, are you using it to create awareness and create change, yeah. social change? Is that, yeah. was Two-Face like that before you had your children?
No, I think I've always been like that. You know, I've always been like that from some songs that I've done way mm-hmm. back. You can hear some of those topics in, mm-hmm. in, you know. So, but I think post-children, mm-hmm. it becomes more serious. It becomes, you know, it becomes, I take it more seriously now.
Mm-hmm. Because you want your children to grow out in a Nigeria that is safe.
In the kind of place that I'm talking about.
Yes. Every morning from 6 to 7, I jog. I have this trainer called Glory. So we're jogging. And he says to me, madam, that's your man. And I'm thinking, what man? Two-Face, that's his album. It's number one in the whole of Africa. Literally, I was like, really? So I get home and I Google it. Number 12 in...
And the Billboard... World
Music Charts. Yeah. I mean, I didn't even know Nigerian music. Debuted on that.
No, that's the first time. Yes, it was history.
But that's phenomenal.
You know, so I'm the first.
I mean, that is phenomenal.
I'm the first grab,
did you know that? Yeah. I mean, it's phenomenal. Yeah. You know, Baba is a PR guru.
Yes, sir.
Isn't this just something?
I've got an interesting story for you.
Really?
3 years ago, I was on a bachelor's stag weekend in Budapest. Mm-hmm. And there was, I was the only black person amongst the boy, you know, 12 English boys. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they said we should go to the strip club. So we went to the strip club and afterwards said we should go to this club. Uh-huh. And I got to this club and everyone literally is white. Obviously, mm-hmm. it's Budapest, yes. in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah.
And then an hour into the night, mm-hmm. guess what came on? Implication.
I can't top that.
Really?
I've heard Implication, same song, mm-hmm. in Istanbul. And it was like, you guys don't even speak English. What's this?
You know, it's phenomenal. No, what I like now. It is insane.
Nigerian music has actually taken over.
Is it true you got shot?
Yeah, a long time ago, some years ago, I think 2008. It was just me coming home from the airport. I just got back from London, that evening. And I just left the airport, heading back home. And then we just got to this small traffic. So as we're just slowing down, this dude just came out of nowhere and tried to open the door. Mm-hmm. Like, open this door. And I'm like, before we could even... react or like even guess what was going on. The guy just raised his hand and brought out the gun and just shot.
Boom. Wow.
Just like that.
Wow.
No bargaining, no negotiation.
I like it. One
so me, I just opened the door and I just took off like that. I told my guy, oh boy, no negotiation. You know.
But when the gun went pow and shot,
I didn't feel it. I just felt something touch there. So I thought it was a glass that shattered that.
Wow. I always imagine that, my goodness, you know, because when you watch films.
So that's why they say, if you go die, you don't go hear the sound. If you hear the sound, that means you never die.
I'm telling you, have you? Is this why?
If you hear the gunshot, you never die.
Mm-hmm. So, father, husband.
Yes, sir.
Responsible musician.
Sometimes.
World acclaimed musician. Nigeria's number one. Export success.
Hey.
Is this why you are using the platform God has given you to do good? Or it must be quite a burden. Mm. I mean, those small shoulders of yours, it's not a lot to carry.
It is.
Because let me go further and tell you what I'm getting at. This vote, not fight.
Yeah, election, no be war.
Abby. Yes, because then that you're talking to the youths and our elders.
Yeah.
You're telling young people, don't fight.
Yeah.
You're telling the elders,
don't instigate any fights. Yes. And I'm like, look, why don't I start up this thing and try to spread the message as vehemently mm-hmm. as possible.
Mm-hmm. I like into the choice the ears of words. As vehemently, yes.
Yeah, into the I ears of the young minds mm-hmm. of Nigeria. And let them know that, look, once you get involved in this thing because of 2,000 naira, because mm-hmm. of 1,000 naira, because of even 10,000 naira, even the amount of money is always ridiculous. Mm-hmm. And the reason why you would go and collect that amount of money to cause this kind of mayhem mm-hmm. on behalf of somebody mm-hmm. is because of the position you are in.
Yeah.
And the position you are in is because of this kind of people.
Mm-hmm.
Because when they get there, they will forget about you.
Absolutely.
The only thing they are good at doing is they give you this 2K mm-hmm. scatter ground. Once they are there, you are forgotten.
And that's it.
You understand? Mm-hmm. So anybody that wants you to do this kind of thing, automatically you know that that person is not ready to make anything happen once mm-hmm. he gets there. I also want to use this to encourage mm-hmm. young Nigerians not only to abstain from violence during the elections, not only to, you know, go out and vote,
mm-hmm.
but also to participate. Like, let them actually get registered in mm-hmm. any political party that they
yes.
choose.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm saying? Because that idea of one part of the country, if you're not in this party, you are the enemy.
You know.
Mm-hmm. Or if you are, you know, that thing has to stop, you know. Mm-hmm. Everybody has a right to choose a political party that they want to support.
Are you planning policies. To get more, you know, more involved in politics in a more formal manner? Are you planning to run
like
for
right,
any kind of
office? Right now that's not in my agenda at all.
Right now you're not.
It's not in my agenda, but I mean, you never know.
It would be good.
But I don't think I'm cut out for politics in that aspect
yes.
of it.
Yeah.
You know, I'm more of a creative kind of person, so...
Well, you're doing your bit.
All those...
That's the important thing. You are doing your bit.
The politics thing, I don't know. Mm-hmm. I can actually support who I believe in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I can, you know, or, you know, but in terms of going into it full-time now, nah. It's not in my plans mm-hmm. yet.
Have you noticed? I'm moving from that serious matter
yeah,
of politics
yeah. yes,
to this.
Sir.
This is what I've noticed. Chita, have you noticed that?
Mm-hmm.
In his videos, and when you see him perform on stage, he has this one dance that he does. And he puts his head up like this. And he's like this. Once in a while, he grabs his crutch. and he's like this, you know.
And he's lost.
Sorry?
And he's lost.
And he's lost in that. And don't forget, he's wearing these dark sunglasses. Okay, so will you teach me that?
No shaking now, why not?
Because I need to go do that at home.
You know.
My
dance, I call it Ras Mike.
Teach me. Now, DJ Spinall. Music. So,
and it's just one step in front, one step behind. Then you just move your... It's a spiritual dance, you understand? This song is not spiritual. This song is not spiritual, but you know.
No, wait, no.
You know, one foot in front, one behind.
No, and
then you just be bending your waist, small, small like that.
No,
but now I'm not shocking. I don't even know shocking.
No, you're killing me here. Oh, my goodness. Oh my goodness. So we'll see you all next week. Thank you for joining me. Thank you. My cool audience, thank you. Mr. Chita, you can't get us to stay in the life. So,
no.
I mean, you just take the politics. But thank you guys so much for being here. DJ Spinall!
Spinall, Lulu.